guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Janny and I'm so glad to have you back. If you are new, hi, welcome. I'm Janny and I'm a second year OBGYN resident. Today we're going to be talking about my 7 financial money tips or money saving tips for physicians, residents, and med students. If you are new, I would love to have you back. So please remember to hit the subscribe button down below and hit the bell to receive all notifications when I upload a new video. You can also follow me on social media. I will link the links down here. So you can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, or my blog to find out what I'm up to. I am most active on Instagram, so you guys can follow me there. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get started with my 7 money-saving tips. So I do not consider myself an expert by any means, but I have been lucky enough to grow up being very financially conscious. So I grew up being encouraged to save, to know a little bit about the importance of having savings, having investments, etc., etc. So this is by no means professional advice. I'm just sharing my tips of things that I think are good things to be doing in terms of your financial security. So tip number 1 is budgeting. So this sounds very obvious and very basic, but it is one of the most important things that you can do. So whether you want to make a very general and broad budget or a very specific, very accountable budget and taking into consideration every single expense that you have, you can do it either way. Both are acceptable and both are good ways to keep track of where your money is going, how much money you are making versus spending. So that gives you an idea of if you are spending more than you are making or if you have enough left over to start putting into savings and thinking about your retirement. So some of the ways that you can do this is through an Excel sheet. So Excel allows you to use their templates for budgeting, and you can use many of the ones that they have. You can create your own. There are many videos out there that show you how to create an Excel budget sheet. I use very basic, the ones that they provide, and it really works for me. It just takes into account what I make every month, what my expenses are every month, and where my money is going in a general sense, but I don't necessarily take into consideration every single expense that I do, just because I've noticed that it doesn't work for me to limit myself in terms of, I can't spend any more on this. So I kind of know in a general sense how much I have left over for going out and things like that, and just leave it in a general sense. Another really good tool to use is Mint. So Mint is a website / application that allows you to link your accounts, whether it is savings, credit cards, investment, student loans, all of your financial stuff in one place. You can link all of your accounts there, and it helps you keep track of your expenses, your due dates for different bills. It allows you to set a budget, set saving expectations, and things like that. They also have advice on different credit cards or loans that you can apply for if you need it. And it's a really good place to have everything. You can have it on the go, you can have it on your phone. Their app is really user friendly. You can set everything up. The only issue that I have is for some reason it keeps signing out some of my accounts, so I keep having to relink them, and sometimes that gives me an error, but it really doesn't bother me that much. It just gives me a general sense. It also tells me when I've incurred account fees, etc., etc. So those are the two things that I would recommend if you are looking into creating a budget. So like I said, budget really allows you to have a general sense of how much money you're making and how much money you are spending, and allows you to see if you need to cut back in certain areas, and allows you to kind of plan if you want to start savings or a retirement account. So talking about retirement accounts, the second point that I have for you is think about your retirement. I cannot stress this enough. And I honestly didn't start thinking about this until last year when I was an intern, and I started looking into if we had a retirement account, which we don't. Our program doesn't provide us with a retirement account, so I wanted to take matters into my own hands, and I decided to open a Roth IRA. There's different ways. There's many videos out there that you can use to educate yourself on the subject, but there's basically three options in terms of retirement accounts. You have a 401k, which is usually supplied by your employer, and a lot of companies allow you to do employer match, which is where they match dollar for dollar every contribution that you put into your 401k until a certain limit. So I would definitely take advantage of that if you do have one, just because you're basically getting free money from your employer towards your retirement, and that is an amazing way to start saving for your retirement. Second, you have an IRA. An IRA is an account that allows you, it basically functions like a savings account, but allows you to invest that money within the account while at the same time keeping some extra money saved in there. With an IRA, you can get deductions based on your contributions to your IRA. If you're looking for tax breaks, that's a really good way to put some money into your retirement, learn a little bit about investing, and get some tax benefit out of it. Third option is a Roth IRA. So a Roth IRA is pretty similar to an IRA, but it's after taxes. So it's money from your own paycheck that you put into an account, and then you invest that money to make it grow, basically. It will grow over time, so you will not see an immediate reward from this investment, but it's a great way to start saving for your retirement. And all the money that is in that account, if you take it out after the age of 59 and a half, then it's all tax free. So you're basically gonna be able to have all the money that you have in that account, you can take it out after 59 and a half and it'll be tax free, which is amazing. Third point that I wanna make is getting a side hustle. So a side hustle is basically something that is making you money on the side. So there are many ways, there's many, many options out there. I have honestly not delved into that too much. I've just been very like superficial about it. But one of the things that you can do is if you own a lot of stuff and you do a purge of your closet, let's say, you can sell these things on Poshmark, eBay, etc., and you can make some money out of that. So Poshmark is a resale application website where you can list your clothes and items for sale. So Poshmark keeps a portion of it and you get a portion of your sale as well. So I've been able to make over almost close to $200 just selling stuff from my closet on Poshmark. So it's a really nice way to make some extra money, you know, supplement your income that way. Especially if you own a lot of things and you think that you can get rid of a lot, you can actually make a lot of money by listing those things on Poshmark. Other options, there's many alternatives out there. There's survey websites that pay you to do surveys. There are transcription services, translation services. There is a whole world of side hustles on the internet that you can take advantage of. They'll probably require some time or some investment of your time, but you will also be able to make some money out of that. So it's kind of like a good bargain where you're at home after your normal working hours and you can still make some money out of that. And my cat is meowing a lot. All of these other alternatives are really good ways to supplement your income. Fourth point in this video is paying off your debt. And I cannot emphasize how important that is, because having credit card debt, having a loan debt, having anything that you are paying interest on, accruing that interest, is not gonna be good if you wanna save some money. So my advice is tackle things with the highest interest first. So that'll be probably your credit cards and your credit lines. So those things, if you can, pay them off as quickly as possible. And I cannot tell you how will that open up the possibilities for you to start saving some money just immediately after you pay off your cards. So recently, in the past 2-3 months, and I've been paying off most of my credit cards, and most of them are at zero right now, and I have so much more money left over every month that I can put into my savings. So that's a way that I have managed to cut out my expenses every month, by paying off my credit cards, and then that way I don't have anything that I owe to anybody at the end of the day. Student loans are a different entity in itself, because the balance is so high that there is no way that I can pay them off while I'm in residency. So what I'm doing is I enlisted in a repayment plan for pay as you earn, and that way they'll calculate a lesser amount than what they normally would for me to pay off every month a lower rate. It's not going to be a substantial amount where I'm going to be like, oh, I paid off this much money of my loans. I probably won't make that much of a difference in the final balance by the time I graduate, but it still looks good for my credit report, and it allows me to contribute to that big loan. And in the matter that I can contribute more to it, it will be more beneficial in the end. So the next point that I have for you is meal prepping and using discounts. The reason that I bring this up is because a lot of places don't offer their residents or their students free food. So if you can cook at home, you can probably save some money by limiting your groceries and making stuff at home and buying less things out, because we all know that the cost of things when you buy them from someone else is going to be a lot higher than if you do it yourself. So by making your own meals and preparing in advance, you can save some money that way. You can also use discounts to buy your groceries and things like that to kind of get everything well-rounded. Another thing that a lot of people do is they calculate how much it would cost for them to eat out versus buy groceries and cook at home versus getting like a meal service. So there's many meal services out there, like HelloFresh, Blue Apron, Every Plate, etc., etc. And all of these services basically provide you portioned out meals, and then you have the meals already ready and you don't have to think about anything, you just have to cook them. There's also other services that provide ready meals that you can buy. You can buy meals for the whole week and they already come pre-packaged. All you have to do is reheat them. So you have to make all those calculations and balance it out and see if you can use discounts for all of these services. What would be the best option for you in terms of how much it costs, how much time it takes for you to do it, and what would be the most feasible option for you. Another thing is that if your hospital does offer like free meals or anything like that, take advantage of all of those, because that's a good way to save money. If you can eat at the hospital, maybe it's not the healthiest food all the time, but it does allow you to save some money. So you kind of have to take your priorities and figure out what would work the best for you. The next point is using energy saving tips or appliances. So making sure that you change all of your light bulbs and make sure that they're as energy friendly as possible, limiting your excessive usage of water, electricity, unplugging things that are not being used, using Energy Star appliances and all things like that. If you can make those changes, that is a little bit of savings that you can have from your monthly bills, that you can contribute that money to your savings. You can mainly get rid of cable or change your phone plan or things like that, just to start saving money here and there. And that's a good way to put that money aside to your savings, and you're already contributing to something other than just paying your bills every month. My last point is using direct savings. So the way that this works is you don't want to think about having to put money away into savings. So just put it as like, either make it a direct deposit from your employer so that you don't even see the money, you don't even miss it, or you can put a direct deposit directly from your account on the day that you get paid so that it goes to a savings account. In terms of savings accounts, you want to have a high interest savings account. So this means an account that pays you over 1.5 to over 2% for interest per year. So some of these accounts I have written down here are like Citibank. They offer 1.85% right now. Discover has 1.6%. Ally has 1.6%. American Express has a savings account that offers 1.7% right now. And Fitness Bank offers 2.2%. Some of these banks offer high interest savings accounts, and they change their rates all the time. So if you can wait for them to get a good offer so you can get a better interest rate, that would be a great way to start making some extra free money as well, because that means that you get more money from the money that's sitting in that bank account. So you want to start thinking about that. You can also have two separate savings account. One can be like your emergency fund, and then the other one is your actual savings account, because you want to save for something. You want to save to buy a house, to buy a car, for a specific trip, anything like that. That way you have two accounts that you can use to put money into and start saving. So growing your savings is going to be a very important part of all that we are talking about today. It's going to be a huge part of your savings, and it's going to be a huge help if you ever run into a situation where you need some money right on the spot. You're not going to be struggling to find the money to pay for a health bill or a car accident or anything like that. You will be covered because you have taken matters into your own hands and have begun to create savings, start investing, thinking about your retirement, and making good financial decisions. So those are my 7 tips. I have some resources here that I think are great that you can look for information. It's directed mostly for physicians, medical students, residents, and they have great advice. I love them. I use them all the time. Whenever I have questions or I want to learn more about a certain topic with regards specifically to being a physician. So White Coat Investor is a great resource. They have videos, they have a blog, they have books that you can read, and they just focus on investing and the importance of investing and savings for physicians. You also have Physicians on Fire, which focuses on financial independence, retire early. So that is basically a choice that some people make. They want to be able to retire early, so they focus mostly in their 20s and 30s on building their retirement accounts, building their savings, and having enough money by X age that they can retire and be comfortable and be set for life, basically. So there is a huge movement on fire, especially in the physician community, because the rates of burnout are so high. So it's a really nice way of thinking about your life and what you want to do. Another good resource is Passive Income MD, and they have a lot of advice and resources for side hustles, other ways that you can make money passively by like real estate investing and things like that. OB Dr. Mom is a personal blog, but she was an OBGYN who had to retire at age 40, and how she was debt free by that time, and they were able to retire, and she has, I think, 1 or 2 kids, and they're doing just fine, but it's all because they started planning early. Life of a Med Student, Student Loan Hero, and The Financial Diet are other 3 resources that I really enjoy looking into whenever I have questions about finances, loans, dealing with student loans, and all of those things. So I will link all of those in the description box down below. So let me know what you guys think, what things that you guys do for saving, investing in your retirement. Is it something that you're thinking about? Did I get you thinking about it? I want to know all about your money and your financial tips down in the comments below. Let's create a discussion and help other residents, med students, and physicians start learning and taking control of their finances. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.